My parents and students, we had a big hearing with dealing with TikTok and what we're to do with this so-called national security situation with TikTok. I want to give you our opinion in the EEP on this. It might be surprising to some of you, but let's take a look at some of the testimony on yesterday. Let's take a look here, okay?
Lawmakers grilling the CEO of TikTok today, accusing the social media company of spying on Americans for China.
TikTok surveils us all, and the Chinese Communist Party is able to use this as a tool to manipulate America as a whole. Your platform should be banned. I expect today you'll say anything to avoid this outcome.
The CEO, Shou Chu, rejecting claims that Beijing has any control over TikTok through its Chinese parent company ByteDance, and insisting that Americans' data is now largely stored on U.S. soil.
Do any ByteDance employees in China, including engineers, currently have access to U.S. data?
Congressman, I would appreciate this. This is a complex topic. Today, all data is stored by default.
No, it's not that complex. Yes or no, do they have access to user data?
We have, after Project Texas is done, the answer is no.
Project Texas is TikTok's name for its ongoing effort to move all U.S. data onto servers.
So some say he didn't really answer the question. I think he's saying right now Chinese Communist Party does have access to the data. But once we get to Project Texas, which is going on the Oracle servers, there could be total United States control of the data. I don't think that's come through in the news coverage as clear as it could be. But let's go on and for sure, I want to make sure. And see, Mike, it's been 2 years ago I heard that. We should investigate why it's taken so long, and who's monitoring it, because I have no confidence that the federal government will monitor it and will hold TikTok to it. But that's actually a separate issue. I want to be sure you know that there was a response given. I keep hearing in the media there was not one given. Let's continue.
Hosted by the American company Oracle, which is based in Texas. That defense, however, falling on deaf ears.
I have seen no evidence that the Chinese government has access to that data. They have never asked us. We have not provided.
I find that actually preposterous.
I don't believe that it is technically possible to accomplish what TikTok says it will accomplish through Project Texas.
Lawmakers provided no evidence that the Chinese government has used the app to surveil Americans, but they repeatedly pointed to an episode from last year when four TikTok employees, including...
So that, I mean, that's kind of, you know, an important point, those of you listening. There was no proof provided of that. Although, if you're asking me what I think, I'm sure the Chinese government Communist Party has access, and they may not need to really get it because they have access many other ways. There was data breaches all over the place with Facebook and them, and they've been hacking into our systems already. I'll say more about this later in the video, and I'm sorry it's such a longer video than I'm doing, but I really want to make sure that I'm extremely fair in my opinion making and my coverage. But there was no proof presented. And the statement that Project Texas won't solve it, I just don't know enough to judge what that senator or congressperson said. I don't know. I sounds like it would be a way if the government would follow up. You know, we could, but, you know, but that brings up, raises other issues that I think are related kind of to the First Amendment. So let's continue.
Including two based in China, were fired after improperly accessing journalist data.
We do not condone the effort by certain former employees to access U.S. TikTok user data in an attempt to identify the source of leaked confidential information.
Even so, governments around the world are moving to ban the app, including the Biden administration, which now prohibits TikTok on federal devices. Secretary of State Antony Blinken calling for the app to, quote, be ended in a separate hearing on Thursday.
Is it a threat to the United States security?
Of course. They don't tell you here that it's banned on government apps, but many of the congresspeople and senators still use it, Democrats and Republicans. We use it in our program. We'll say more about that. I don't understand why that wasn't stated here by CNN or by Fox. I heard the Fox coverage earlier and Newsmax too. So either side of the journalistic spectrum is not fully, you know, being honest here about this. I thought CNN's was okay. That's why I presented it here. But you need to know that that's clearly not being stated. Let's go ahead and continue still, though, okay?
Security. I believe that it is, yes. And shouldn't a threat to United States security be banned?
It should be ended one way or another, and there are different ways of doing that.
The chairman of the Senate Intelligence Committee also hinting that the U.S. knows more about TikTok's risks than has been publicly revealed.
One of the things that my legislation would do is require the intelligence community to declassify as much information as possible, so it's not, don't just trust the government.
So, Jake, the CEO of TikTok clearly trying to convince lawmakers here that TikTok does not pose a national security threat to the United States because the parent company that owns TikTok, ByteDance, does not have a lot of control over the use and where the U.S. data actually goes, because that data is being stored on American servers in Texas, overseen by an American company. But the underlying theme of this entire hearing was lawmakers essentially telling him that they do not believe him. And I should note that TikTok issued a statement after this hearing.
I guess very accurate. It's just them saying they don't believe him. I don't see a basis for banning it. They may ban it, but I don't think it's going to make us more secure. And then how do you enforce the ban? I have to know more about how the ban is enforced and whether it will be enforced by the administration. I want to hear from the Justice Department whether they're going to prosecute people under this. I feel the same way about this as I feel. I'm generally opposed to banning things because we have free will from a spiritual standpoint. And we need to decide to follow God on other things every day. If everything's banned, then, you know, what is it really all about? So let's just finish this up so I can give you my full view.
Saying that while Xu, the CEO, tried to answer lawmakers' questions, the hearing was dominated by, quote, political grandstanding.
I don't know about aliens.
All right, so there you see my the broadcast there. Let's dive into what we think in EEP about this discussion, what we really are saying about it. And I think you'll see rationally, you know, where we stand on it. Okay. Well, the number one reason people give for banning TikTok, the politicians and others, is that it's a national security issue, and that China has access to the data, and they seem to think they can use it to control our opinions and control elections. But I'm not sure they don't already have that. I mean, in a free society like we have, with the overwhelming power of big tech in our lives and the amount of time we spend on, you know, these things right here, especially our young people, I'm not so sure you can blame that on TikTok. And you might say, well, we got to start somewhere, but what about Google? Google has plants in China. They've helped China. They're helping China with this military things. And you think they're not sharing data and analytics with China? I don't know about that. How about Facebook? Last year, Meta sending all that data to the Chinese. It came out very quietly, got out of the news too. I have trouble, you know, with the national security thing. I mean, we ought to be having an ongoing debate about the influence the Chinese and Russians and others already have on our big tech, on that data, and also on our big tech companies, you know, having a waiver of Section 230, which they can't be sued ever. We need to investigate the power we give to big tech. But that's all separate from TikTok. TikTok, banning TikTok, you know, then as for banning anything, remember prohibition, you ban things. Are you willing to now lock people up because of it? And if so, is it a First Amendment violation? I'm not really flowing real smoothly with this idea of banning a company. I'm in favor of telling the consumers all about it. I mean, we use TikTok here. I'll talk about that in a bit. And I've looked at whether we should keep using it because of all this. And I'll tell you a little bit about my conclusion. But I'm not so sure that it's national security, a real national security issue, the way other people say it is. Next, this business, I saw the quote earlier. Maybe I'll play that video later. I have something else to say about that, where we had a Black congressperson saying that it's racist to ban TikTok. That's not the reason why I'm against banning it. I don't think it's racist. I think I've heard the national security thing a lot, and him pretending it's a race issue, I found it somewhat offensive. Whenever I see things compared to the Black civil, make it made into civil rights issues, I begin to think that they're equating it with the civil rights issues in the civil rights movement. Particularly, I see a Black politician doing it. I don't know if I'm comfortable with that. And I'll show the video later. So we use it in EEP. It guarantees our direct communication with Generation Z, and we've had students come to us with FAFSA issues through a recent shorts that we've done on TikTok that we tried out on TikTok before we had our social media expert put us on there officially. So we already had one inquiry from the one she put up the other day. So Gen Z is looking at TikTok and they regard it as a key way they get information. So we're not going to leave there unless the government forbids it and bans it. We will follow the law. But until then, we have no intention of getting off the platform right now. We don't, just like Instagram. Should we leave Instagram? It's the same thing. Instagram is hugely involved in this body shaming situation with young women. And the crazy things I see young women doing online and showing their bodies and doing inappropriate, and guys too. Guys are doing sexually inappropriate things on Instagram as well, which brings up the issue of what should parents do. And we'll get to that about that. But again, those are all separate issues from should it be banned. I think I'm looking at that right. I mean, for us, if we're going to get off TikTok, we got to get off Instagram. And we've got a lot of great connections there with parents and students. So, in fact, one of our SAT prep classes, we found a student from the Philippines on the Instagram. So, I'm sorry, it's a way for us to communicate spiritually and career-wise and educationally with Generation Z. I don't know a better way right now to reach out to the world and communicate with them. It's a wonderful way. Of the 150 million TikTok subscribers, I think it's 200 million in the United States on Instagram. All right. Well, why are we opposed to, you might wonder, there's an opposition, or I would say a cynicism also in EEP, to age restrictions. You can say, well, 13-year-olds can't come on, whatever. But how do you enforce it? I need someone to clearly tell me, because I know that underage kids are getting on it now and there's restrictions. So age restrictions doesn't convince me. The key in all this is parents, as you see in a moment. We like the idea of parental controls digitally on desktop computers. We'll get to the cell phone in a minute. I think that every desktop in every house, there should be parental controls that prevent accessing all kinds of things. You know, not just TikTok and Instagram and those things. You should restrict, porn websites. You should restrict many of these stars have these crazy, bizarre gender-related sites. They should be restricted. There are ways of doing that very easily through parental controls. We're going to investigate that and tell you more about that here very soon. I'm going to look into that very soon. But that's just the desktop, right? That's not going to help you with their cell phone and their iPads and those devices, which I'll get to next. So we like the idea of parental controls. Age controls, I'm not sure how that's going to work. Sure, I'm not opposed to it, but it makes it a little harder, but not much if they really want to get on. There are a lot of underage kids on TikTok. We know that. There's underage kids in all kind of stuff online with their cell phones they should not be online with. So what is the solution to that? We'll talk about that in a minute. So the underage banning, I don't know. What about other bans on social media? Are we going to ban Google? I mean, you know, I don't think you can do much about those. And this brings up the whole issue, I think, of is the federal government protecting the data that flows out of this country? I mentioned that earlier. That's another issue here. But again, this TikTok thing should be bringing up a debate about those things, but I'm not hearing it. I think I'm hearing the only thing the media is talking about is whether it should be banned or not. And you heard what I thought about that. Finally, there's a spiritual call to parents here to get more control of the computers in your house and the capabilities of your students' cell phones. I'm going to research whether there are controls and apps that can be put on cell phones that can control access to things. I don't think there is a lot of that being done. So a lot of it is we the horse is out of the barn, the toothpaste out of the tube. You just got to do the best you can, parents, by restricting where in the house it's used. When they go out, they're going to have their cell phone, and I don't think you're going to be wanting to take it from them because they'll get all upset. They'll have withdrawal pains because there's a serious addiction to it. So I don't think you can do anything now that they're teenagers, they're going away to college. There's not a lot you're going to do, even when they're in high school, if you've already had them using it for years. The solution is, parents, my parents of your fourth and fifth graders, let's not give them very powerful iPhones and powerful digital devices. Let's give them flip phones to call us. Let's give them very simple phones without a lot of digital access and data access, and then control laptops at home, desktops at home, laptops controlled. That's the way to go, and then they won't get addicted. So you say, what about their friends? Well, you can't stop that, but you made it harder by them not having it, and they're not going to let them use their phones all the time. And then remember this, you also should be controlling how much money and access to money they have, so they can't buy a phone. Stop giving them a lot of money. So there are ways to make it extremely hard for them to get addicted to these apps like TikTok and Instagram, and yes, have a deleterious effect on their lives. I think middle school, elementary school, you should be restricting it. And by the time they're in high school, maybe the third year, they can get their first phone like that. And they won't have you're not going to be telling them how to put apps on it, are you? They might learn about apps and do things, but they're far older and they're not going to be addicted. I looked at my youngest daughter, Andrea. She is an extremely responsible user of social media. And I bet a lot of it's because we didn't let her, we got smart. We didn't let her have a lot of access early on. Her mother and I never talked about it much, but we realized after the first one, it was an issue. The first two, and whether it was consciously or subconsciously, she didn't get a lot of access through her cell phone. And to this day, she may have those apps, but she's not in any way controlled by it. I would say I'm more into it than she is. So I think that's a solution. Get them at an early age. I know it doesn't solve the problem of the older ones. And also in your house, make it difficult to have solitary use, you know, like in the bathroom, in their bedroom. It should be a house rule that phones are regularly taken away at night. There's no reason to have that. Even if you have a flip phone, they should be making calls at night. All that will make their grades go up too. I think their grades will get better as well. Somebody said they'll hate me. I don't know about that. You build a good, strong home, those controls, they never get addicted to it. They'll tell you other kids are doing crazy stuff on their phones. They'll be with you. If you train up a child in the way they should go, when they grow older, they will not depart from it. So if you train them up that way to not be dependent on social media, that's the way they go. They'll go. I hope that helps to know what I think about the TikTok stuff that's going on and in general about how EET feels about social media. I can see my cat is pretty happy about it too. God bless you all. Give me some comments below and let me know that you saw this and whether it's something that's helpful to you at this time. I'll be praying for you, what you do in response to all this talk about TikTok and whether you create a dialogue within yourself and with our God in your lives as to what you'll do in your home. Bye-bye now.